Brother, look. That strange bugger popped back out of the ground again.
It's too fast.
Then how shall we catch it?
Flank it. Attack from behind.
Good.
You did it. Let's see. What a drop. Father, up there. Nista.
Halfway there. There's gotta be another chain to lower the rest of the gate. Look, there's a chain we can pull up there. Father, up there. It's clinging to the wall. We gotta knock it down.
You can uncover that geyser from here? Oh, I think I get it. If you freeze the geyser, the pressure will turn the wheel. Coming down.
Maybe you could try hitting the rope holding the block. Maybe you could try hitting the rope holding the block.
Nice one. What about freezing the geyser under the wheel? Maybe?
Maybe you could try hitting the rope holding the block. That's one of Cavassier's poems. Very highbrow. You should collect any others you find. Lad, if I may, what exactly are you hoping to learn from Tyr?
Well, like I said, I was hoping he could tell me something about Loki. I'd also like to hear some of his stories. Traveling to other lands, giant stuff, and maybe about what it was like to fight back in the day. Just for the history, obviously.
History?
Let's hope Tyr's in a talkative mood after being imprisoned for so long. Not all of Odin's captives can be as charmingly voluble as myself.
We have no proof Tyr is truly here.
Right. That earthquake earlier, do you think there will be another one?
It's unlikely, but geological disturbances tend to be unpredictable.
If the geysers and smell here are worse because of Fimbulwinter, maybe the earthquakes are too?
Aye. You might be onto something, lad.
Atreus, look ahead.
Wow, now this looks like a city.
Welcome to Nidavellir, brothers.
Hey, dwarves! Oh. They're, running away.
An alarm.
I'd only sound an alarm like that if I still had my body and was fearing the notion of being detached from it.
Why all that for us, though?
They are scared.
Was definitely an alarm, I'm afraid.
Why is everybody hiding?
Stay alert.
Hey! Could we talk to you for...
We don't want any trouble, please.
There'll be no help, to be sure. Best we find the tavern Sindri mentioned on our own. And hope they let us in.
The buildings here really are incredible.
The detail in the woodwork is quite extraordinary.
Is that a statue of Odin? They must really love him here.
Or fear him.
Yeah. Sindri!
Hello. I'd return your surprise, but I did know you'd be here. I've got something for you.
Thanks for grabbing this.
What is it, Dwarf?
You know, I'm glad I came back here at least once before Ragnarok.
Oh, if these cobblestones could talk.
Then they'd have mouths. Filthy, disgusting mouths.
Do you mind if I fiddle with your bow?
Ugh, you are long overdue for a replacement. Taking advantage of certain material... Ow! Structural sensitivity to sonic vibrations has been something... I've been meaning to try for quite some time now.
Thanks for, finally trying it. What's it gonna be this time?
Patience! I find it's best to see these things... in action.
There.
Oh, take aim at that gate there. But before you loose, say Skialfa.
Well, I certainly didn't expect you to disturb half the creepy crawlies in Nidavellir.
How was I supposed to know they were there?
Right flank!
Brother, get up, brother!
Okay, so, Dirlin. Sindri, any idea where the tavern is?
Do I look like I've ever been to a filthy tavern? The sewer you just punched a hole through seems promising, though. For you. It should lead to the other side of the city. It's not like you're able to open other doors around here.
So this lockdown really is because of us?
Oh, my, yes. Odin's grip on this realm is so firm, any outsider is considered a threat.
Sounds like an Odinism if I ever had one.
Another of Cavassier's poems.
At your service. What can I make for you? Everything all right? That might be my best piece yet today. Why are you just standing? Is it because I helped Atreus? Is this meant to scare me? Well, you should know, it's working. I'll disinfect my tools. Why are you just standing? Is it because I helped Atreus? Is this meant to scare me? Well, you should know, it's working. Be safe. Best of luck.
Any outsider is considered a threat. Is that to protect the dwarves?
It sounds like it. But knowing Odin, there's sure to be an ulterior motive.
Well, everyone's hiding on this side too.
Odin's occupation of this realm has its hooks in deep.
But there aren't any guards patrolling. We're clearly not a threat. Why hide?
Resist and you're made an example of. To keep the rest in line. Self-preservation can outweigh bravery for even the strongest of folk.
Fear keeps them safe and alive.
Tavern's gotta be around here somewhere. Maybe we can try knocking on some doors for directions. I think I see something. Could you maybe...
No! Thank you!
Excuse me, but we're looking for...
Nothing for you here. I don't care what you want. No food, no encouraging words, no nothing. Leave!
This looks promising, right? Well, it's like a house. If he's here, maybe you should let me do the talking.
You?
Well, we don't want to intimidate him. You're tall as a tree and you have a severed head on your head.
None taken. Fair point, though.
Very well.
Hello?
Watch yourselves. Apparently, there are intruders about.
Oh, that's us, I think.
Well, if you're planning on killing me, at least let me finish this song. That alarm was in just the perfect key.
We're just looking for a friend of ours named Derlin.
Well, we both know that's not true. Derlin's got no friends left. But if that's all you need, head out the back way there. And you'll see the safety office just across the river. Just don't go making trouble for the rest of us. And while you travel through this realm, maybe you could clean up the head's mess?
What mess?
Later, brother.
wish to hear of this mess?
The rig's in the bay. Why don't you ask the condescending skull?
Head, I've got skin. But he's right. I made a mistake. I'd have us shut them down.
Sorry, one more thing. Although, these are gifts I'm giving to you, so I shouldn't be sorry and you should be thankful. Anyways, here, please be careful.
It's beautiful. Thanks, Sindri.
It is beautiful, isn't it? It's also very useful. You'll be able to find anything your heart desires with it.
Really?
As long as your heart desires the locations your father and you decide and plot to travel together, then yes.
It is a compass.
Ah, but a beautiful compass. Now scamper off.
Come. A boat cannot be far.
Huh. Earlier, Sindri made it sound like Durlan was some sort of rebellion leader. Doesn't sound like anyone's following him.
Was being the key word here, little brother.
I saw a dock back there. Maybe there's a boat we can use to get to Durlan's. There's a building just past these rocks behind me. Maybe we should head that way.
Ugh, those bloody mining rigs.
What about them?
The Skald is right to blame me for them. They were my idea. If you've got the time, they're in the bay just beyond this tunnel.
I'd particularly appreciate us checking out the mining rigs in the lake to the right. You can see the smokestacks from here.
But if you don't want to explore now, it looks like Durlan's place is through that open gate to the left. So, which way do we go? We could prepare more before rescuing Tyr. Up to you. Mimir, were you really the one who had those rigs built?
Odin wanted the dwarves under his control and, well, I convinced him he could buy their allegiance instead of demanding it outright. A trade agreement of sorts.
father, is it always moral to kill something that's trying to kill you?
Yes.
Well, there you have it, lad.
One of the mining rigs is here.
See the smoke above us? That's where we're headed. Let's see if we can't shut it down.
Didn't like working for Asgard. Couldn't they just quit?
And do what? Their newly built forges poisoned the soil of Svartalfheim. Unable to grow their own food, they had to buy it from Asgard. If they stopped working, they'd be taking food out of their own mouths.
Oh, that's clever. And awful.
Right side!
Whoa, an Yggdrasil seed to Muspelheim. Think it might lead to that combat arena we visited years ago?
What makes you say that?
Wishful thinking, I guess. Going through Surtur's gauntlet, it was fun.
It was training.
You didn't have fun?
Hmm.
Well, anyway, we should look for the other half of the seed. Once it's whole again, we can see where it leads. Now we can make it across.
Go!
Just keep coming!
It's a bear trap! Spawning of us wretches like there's no tomorrow!
The hide will be so!
Materials that could help us. I'd grab whatever it spits up in the process.
Dwarves agreed to the deal with Asgard. Why do they blame you?
I talked them into their own exploitation.
They made their choice.
Work or die is not a choice. I only made it seem so. Brother, before we leave, perhaps it might serve us to check the rig and see if it spat anything up. What? Just picked up there is pure Spartalfheim ore. It won't be of use in the rig anymore, but perhaps our Huldra brothers could craft something from it.
How did these rigs come to be?
I had them built to harvest ore for armaments. Essentially harnessing resources that would otherwise go to the dwarves.
You think shutting these things down will help the dwarves become independent?
I don't know, but I have to try something.
Is that a watchtower?
Taking a break before visiting Durlan?
Very wise.
He can be a lot. Whatever you need. I'll heat up the forge.
Good fit.
Take care of your armor, and it'll take care of you. Thank you.
off!
Hey, it's another one of those geysers, but huge. Maybe we could check it out later.
We can see it fine from here.
Mimir, how many stories have you told about Odin and Thor, and all the bad things they've done? Let's see how many we can remember. Seems like Father could use his memory refreshed.
My memory of them requires no refreshment. They invaded our home.
Yeah, but I'm talking about history. All the other people they've hurt. Let's see. Okay. There was Thalmor, the stonemason.
Aye. He quarreled with his son. Went into the night to find him. Found Thor instead.
And there was Thalmor's son, Hrimthor.
Who built the walls of Asgard. And whispered something of importance to Freyr before his betrayal and assassination.
There was Groa, of course.
The knowledge keeper and prophet of Ragnarok. Thor murdered her husband, and Odin covered it up before doing her in himself.
You can't forget Ymir, the first giant.
Odin carved him up to form the realms from his body, and let the torrent of his blood nearly drown every giant alive.
What about the giants of Jotunheim? They all seemed dead when we finally made it there.
That remains a mystery. Well, admittedly, it sounds like the Aesir god's dream.
What about Fjorgyn? Thor's mother was a giant, wasn't she?
Indeed she was. The circumstances of her demise were murky at best, but not sure I can blame Odin for that one. He wasn't the same after.
Oh, I know. There was Skag, queen of the hunt.
Aye, she spurned Odin's affections, so he tricked her into killing her father.
There was Starkather the Mighty, the Jotnar military leader.
Slandered by Odin, tricked and murdered by Thor.
And there was Thrym the Cunning, the giant king who stole Thor's hammer.
Odin traded him Freyr to get it back, and sent Thor in disguise to murder his entire court.
Ah, Grungnir the Brawler, the stone giant.
Aye, mocked by Odin. Murdered by Thor.
Enough of this.
But there's more.
I do not care. War with Odin is not the answer.
Ymir. What do you think it means? Seeing more raiders come back as Hellwalkers lately. I thought freeing the Valkyrie Queen was supposed to restore balance to the realms, and keep that from happening.
That's a good question, lad.
Enough. We will continue later.
There's another mining rig on this island, brother. Smell that smoke?
Why would the dwarves agree to work for the Aesir in the first place?
That's the heart of it, eh?
You lied to them.
I lied to them.
Bet we could swing across that, lift thing.
Gantry.
Gantry. Thanks.
Yeah.
Not quite right.
Gotta be the right spot.
Those barrels. I smell fuel. Bet a spark from your blades would cause quite a boom.
I think we could break through the ground here, if he found a high enough place to drop from.
Huh?
Surprised the dwarves didn't shut these rigs off themselves.
One or two tried. The Einherjar made examples of them.
They killed the dwarves? Can you have convinced them not to?
Aye.
That should help.
Impressive.
I don't think we can reach it there.
Yeah, that looks right. Okay, Mimir?
To the blacksmiths of Svartalfheim, the creation of a weapon was a sacred thing. But Odin just wanted as many blades as he could get, as fast as he could get them. With every stolen resource and mediocre blade, the dwarves lost a bit of themselves.
The dwarf survived because of you.
Ah, you're not wrong there, brother. Odin would have wiped out every last dwarf in Svartalfheim. If he couldn't use their skills, no one could.
So not all dwarves can do that thing Brock and Sindri do, right? Where they just walk between realms and turn up somewhere else?
Indeed, that's a rare skill. I gather one carefully cultivated by some secretive dwarven guild or other. Probably for the best. Them alone doing it is disconcerting enough.
Thank you.
Hello? Huh. Seems abandoned.
Get off of me!
more special equipment to use this.
What is it, Lemire?
That's nothing, brother. Just... you ever have those moments where you wish you could... go back? Rewrite your own past. Make different decisions.
Journeying through time is more trouble than it is worth.
Ah, fair point. You're speaking metaphorically, right?
No.
Of course you're not.
Mir, what's the deal with Odin's ravens? They can just transport him anywhere?
Except for the realm between realms, thankfully.
Why?
Harder to find, thanks to dwarven enchantments and Yggdrasil's very own nature.
Hmm. Lucky us.
Yeah, I don't think we can do anything with that yet.
Mir, a little while ago you mentioned Odin's ravens. What's to stop him from using them to pop into existence and kidnap anybody he wants?
Consent. The only way to travel by Odin's ravens is by your own choice.
Oh, it's not so bad then.
Father, look. We can chisel through this door.
Oh, glad to see that still works.
Nice. Father, I wanted to ask you something about your blades. The ones from your homeland.
What of them?
Why don't you just throw them away? I see the way you look at them sometimes. Like you're... I don't know. Like you hate them.
Even hateful things have their uses. Besides, I tried. They came back.
Father, what was Spartan training like?
Unforgiving.
Is that why you didn't train me like one? Did you not think I could handle it?
I did not think you should have had to.
Thanks.
No. This is... It can't still be here.
What?
There's a key on this island. I need you to find it, brother. An innocent life is at stake.
Rich! Left foot! coming out of that net. Wreckers on the left! You gotta handle that net so they won't stop coming.
Left side!
One more to go!
Hey, you watch out!
Mimir, you said an innocent life was at stake. Did Odin trap somebody here?
No, lad. I did.
Ground looks weak down here, Father. That gear looks like it would freeze. Maybe that lift can help us get higher. Might be easier to break that ground from up there. Hey, what if we climbed over to the lift? The ground from up there?
The key we're looking for. Now we must head to that watchtower on the shore. Just need you to trust me.
Father, what's the biggest thing you've ever fought?
I do not know.
You can't remember?
Why do you ask?
I don't know. So we can compare?
It is not a competition.
I mean, not yet. Can you hear that?
No.
Thought I heard a voice.
Let's keep going, lad. Just put the key into that lock, brother. Give that drum a good loud strike.
That's the voice I heard.
I'd hoped it would have escaped by now, but...
We'll need to free it from its restraints.
What is this?
A Loonbocker. I captured it many years ago.
Yuffa!
What is this?
A Lungbocker. I captured it many years ago. Bloody Draugr holes! You've got to clear out all these undead bastards!
You're on fire, Kratos! It will burn!
What is this?
A Lungbocker. I captured it many years ago. Bloody Draugr holes! We've got to clear out all these undead bastards!
You're on fire, but you probably already know that.
Atreus. You are getting better. Faster.
I'd even be better than you one day, huh?
If you are not, I have failed. This creature, you enslaved it.
Aye.
But why?
Because I was young and stupid. And I didn't know what it was like to be chained in one place for years at a time, with nothing to occupy your mind but pain. Right. Chain the fins too. If you could.
That creature's hurting.
But we're going to free it.
But it will always be chained. You know that as well as I.
Now for the other thing. There may be a way to reach it behind that collapsed debris. With me, aren't you, brother?
I remember the feeling of a yoke around my neck. I would not wish it upon another.
Good thing you learned the runes, brother. More inspiring lyricism from the mind of Thrasea.
Enslave the creature.
Its fat was a good source of oil for Odin's lanterns.
Oil for lanterns?
Whatever anger you're feeling, whatever loathing toward me, it's nothing to what I've said to myself.
I know.
Just the tail left now.
Look out! Rechnet!
Behind you!
Look out! Was hiding some sort of device.
There's a dock down there, but it looks like it's blocked.
Maybe that dock can lead us to the tail. Let's get back to the boat.
You never spoke of this creature.
Does that surprise you? That an old man would be ashamed of the mistakes he's made?
No. Thank you.
I'd thought, I'd hoped the creature would be long expired by now. But apparently the Aesir couldn't even be bothered to mercy kill it once it was no longer useful.
We could kill it.
No. Not when we can save it. Good. We can reach the tail from this dock.
You would still save this broken creature.
I know what it is to be imprisoned like this. I can't just leave it.
And if it is beyond saving?
I don't understand.
Let us continue.
Watch your left!
Go!
Tail must be chained as well. Sliding down that rope should take us where we need to go. Encouragement. Can you get me closer to its eye for a face-to-face, brother?
Creature. The mining rigs. They're mistakes, Mimir. But it's Odin's fault.
That's not an excuse, little one. But thank you for saying it.
on, you great blubbering beast! Shoo!
It's not moving.
Why is it not moving?
It has grown accustomed to its chains.
But... no. No, we can fix this. We just need to chase it off and scare it. Something.
There is no making things right. Only better than they were.
It likes the wind blowing on its face. I can feel it.
May it provide some comfort.
That's not enough.
It seldom is.
Mimir, wouldn't you prefer to face forward rather than backward?
We already tried.
There were issues with Viscera.
Oh.
There was a brief bit where I thought I might get used to it.
He did not.